Younger Dryas Comet. Angle of Impact. The newly discovered impact crater in Greenland opens the possibility that several pieces of a comet hit the Earth 12,900 years ago. In this image, a swarm of comet fragments approach the Earth on a collision course. Two potential Younger Dryas impact sites have been identified. One impact hit the northern part of Greenland, producing a crater that is now under the Hiawatha Glacier. Another impact hit Saginaw Bay at the southernmost edge of the Laurentide Ice Sheet and ejected a dense curtain of glacier ice boulders in ballistic trajectories that created the Carolina Bays and killed the North American megafauna from the Rocky Mountains to the east coast of the United States. The water ejected by the extraterrestrial impact on the ice sheets created a fog of ice crystals in low Earth orbit that blocked the light of the sun and triggered the Younger Dryas cooling event that lasted 1,300 years. Tidal forces disintegrate comets. The rush limit is the minimum distance to which a celestial body held together only by its own gravity can approach a second celestial body without being torn apart by tidal forces. In 1992, comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 was disintegrated by the tidal forces of Jupiter into a string of smaller pieces. In July of 1994, these pieces collided with Jupiter, leaving a trail of spots in the atmosphere, some of which were larger than the Earth. The planets of the solar system have fairly circular orbits, but comets have highly elliptical orbits that may take them beyond the orbits of all the planets. As we have seen with Jupiter, collisions can happen when the orbits of comets and planets intersect. Comets contain materials that evaporate when the comet approaches the Sun. Gases and dust emanate from the comet and form a tail that is blown by the solar wind. This is why the tail of a comet always points away from the Sun. A comet that has circled around the Sun will continue in its orbit and approach the Earth coming from the Sun. If a comet breaks apart by the tidal forces of the Sun, the pieces will continue along the previous orbit and the pieces may collide with the Earth. A second opportunity for a collision occurs when the comet comes back toward the Sun and crosses the Earth's orbit. If the comet became fragmented during its path around the Sun, the comet pieces may be scattered by the gravitational fields of the outer planets. Jupiter and Saturn may capture comets and comet fragments. These gas giants also change the trajectories of comet debris and reduce the possibility of collisions with the Earth when the pieces come back toward the Sun compared to when the pieces were coming from the Sun. This globe of the Earth has the axis of rotation tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees relative to the ecliptic plane, which is the imaginary plane of the Earth's orbit around the Sun. In this photograph, we see the reflection of the Sun along the Tropic of Cancer, which is the most northerly circle of latitude on Earth at which the Sun can be directly overhead. This corresponds to the summer solstice in the northern hemisphere, sometimes between June 20 and June 22. The arrows indicate the trajectories that the comet pieces coming from the Sun would have taken to strike Greenland and Saginaw Bay. In this photograph, we see the reflection of the Sun along the Tropic of Capricorn, which is the most southerly circle of latitude on Earth at which the Sun can be directly overhead. This corresponds to the summer solstice in the southern hemisphere, which occurs between December 20 and December 23. The arrow shows that the trajectories of comet pieces coming from the Sun would not be able to hit Saginaw Bay or Greenland at this time. From the orientation of the Earth in the solar system and the large number of comets orbiting along the ecliptic plane, we have to conclude that if the Earth was hit by a disintegrating comet 12,900 years ago, the most likely time was during the summer when both Greenland and Saginaw Bay could be reached by fragments of a comet coming from the Sun. Thus far, two candidate impact sites have been proposed, but there could be more that have not been discovered yet. Erosion by wind and water rapidly destroy evidence of impacts on the Earth, and impacts on the ice sheets during the Ice Age might have left no trace. There may also have been pieces of the comet that missed the Earth 12,900 years ago. Could these pieces return one day and hit the Earth? We take much pleasure watching meteor showers and shooting stars. but knowing that these are pieces of comets makes us aware that not all pieces may burn harmlessly in the Earth's atmosphere. It is a scary thought.